Across the sport of college football, senior nights are always emotional. And at UNLV tonight, for Lexington Thomas and the Rebels, not just senior night, but rivalry nights. And that rival comes from the north, Nevada and UNLV. They play for the Fremont Cannon. And the Cannon has belonged to Nevada the last 2 years. Hi, everybody. Rich Waltz along with Aaron Murray. AJ Ross will join us shortly. It is a rivalry, and at times this rivalry can get nasty.
It get a little testy, a little fun on the field, maybe a couple jabs here and there, but this is what football is. You throw out the records, I don't care, you're winning, you're losing, playing well, playing bad. These type of games, a little extras added to it, it's a lot of fun to watch.
Nevada is one of the best stories of the year. They had 3 wins last year, win this game, and they've got 8 this year.
It's a tough thing for a new coach and Jay Norvell. Get the team to buy into what you're selling offensively, defensively. You turn on the tape year 2, they bought in. They're playing great defensively, offensively, the air raid attack, and this is why they're having so much success. This is why they have a chance to win 8 games.
And for a guy like Ty Ganji, he was here on the lean times, and it's great to see him enjoy and really drive this team now.
Well, it's good to see him healthy, too, because when he's healthy, he's not only a great thrower, Rich, he has the ability to take off with his legs. He's very agile. He's dynamic. He keeps defenses honest.
You want a quarterback who can do it with his legs? UNLV's quarterback is finally healthy. Armani Rogers is a big man. He can throw it, but more often than not, he's going to run it.
He does. He's a cannon for an arm, but his ability to take off and run really opens up this offense, helps out with Lexington Thomas, helps out with the receiver. So I'm excited to see what he can do tonight.
Oh, you said Thomas. His nickname is Lightning.
He is Lightning. I tell you what, you give him any kind of crease from a defense, he's going to take it. He's going to hit it. It's not just 3, 4, 5 yards. They need these home runs tonight. If they're going to want to stay in this ball game, he's going to need another 50, 60, 70-yard touchdown to continue his great season.
Jay Norvell, year 2, and his second crack at UNLV in this rivalry game. They won last year up in Reno. And Tony Sanchez, in his 4th season as the head coach at UNLV. He's got a healthy Armani Rogers, and his team has played well the last 2 weeks. They upset San Diego State 2 weeks ago. They had Hawaii beaten into the third, but collapsed late over on the islands.
Yeah, they're playing better. We talk about it. They're buying into this system, too, from the UNLV side. They're getting better and better. Most importantly, Rich, they're healthy right now. That's why you're seeing them play better football.
Good, strong kick by Ramiz Ahmed. And so UNLV gets the football first from their 25-yard line. Summon the cow. A little Chick-fil-A starting lineups. And there he is, all 6'5", 225 pounds of him.
And Al's out there pregame, Rich, watching him throw, watch him move around. He looks comfortable. He's getting healthier and healthier each and every week. I want to see if he can win this game with his arms. We know what he can do with his legs, but if he can throw the ball accurately down the field, it's a new dynamic to this offense.
Lexington Thomas. It's a good run defense of Nevada. The offense for UNLV, some weapons on the outside, including Brandon Presley.
Yeah, we talk about, obviously, new quarterback and more of a runner in Armani Rogers, but he is getting more comfortable as a pocket passer. So these receivers like Brandon Presley on the outside, they're going to get some one-on-one opportunities. They got to take advantage of it.
Second down and 8. Thomas, nice stop and start, but he's planted at the 32. They'll bring up 3rd down and 5. Nevada's defense really good right now, and Malik Reed has made the transition from defensive end to linebacker.
Oh, it's been seamless for him, and they're going to move him all over the place. He's going to be defensive end. He may stand up at times in 3rd down situations, according to the coaching staff. He's a guy as an offense. You got to be aware of him, because if he gets one-on-one with a tackle or a guard, you got to double team him. He's too good at getting after the quarterback.
On 3rd down, Rogers' first carry, and he's tripped up. That's Lucas Weber, the senior linebacker, coming up to make the play, and well short of the 1st down.
And we're seeing it early on right now in this first possession for UNLV. The game plan, they want to make this game go by quicker. They want to shorten it up by running the football, keep the clock going. They can do that now with Armani Rogers, and Nevada knows that as well. They're going to stack the box to stop the run.
Is that because they don't have the firepower of Nevada?
No, they don't at all, and they realize that, and they just want to make sure they can keep this game close into the fourth quarter.
Good, strong kick. Fair catch called for and made there by Caleb Fossum, and back comes the cow. Our Chick-fil-A starting lineups. Ty Ganji was banged up in the middle of the season, but he's healthy, and this offense is rolling.
Oh, and he's been on a tear during this four-game win streak right now. 8 touchdowns, 1 pick. And he said it best, he's healthy right now, because when he can move around in the pocket, extend plays, plenty of talent at the receiving position, even at the running back, it's tough to cover those guys for 5-6 seconds down the field when he's running around.
First play for the Wolfpack. Ganji will pull it and throw it. Lobs it down the middle, and it's caught there. Romeo Dubs. Inside Rebel territory to the 38-yard line.
That's a great job. He actually had two receivers open right there. Mannix was wide open in the slot. The safety's bit. He went to the outside, just a double post. Great job shedding off the DB. Wants to grab his arm. Powers right through it to get the big play to start this game off.
That's 41 yards from Ganji to Dubs. A lot of talent on the outside for Nevada. Quick throw there into traffic. Is it picked? It's incomplete. Almost intercepted. Jericho Flowers almost ended up with it. It was intended for McLean Mannix.
And one of the keys for UNLV's defense is to lock up these talented slot receivers. You see it right there. They're going to hug these guys close to the line of scrimmage, about 4 or 5 yards. Don't let them get a good start. Ty Ganji loves going to his talented receivers on the inside, Mannix and Fossum.
And you saw the ball clearly pressed against the turf and not in control. Second down, 10. First carry for Kelton Moore, and he busts loose, and Moore's to the 10, Moore's to the 5-yard line, and knocked out of bounds there. Big gain, and a great sequence for that offensive line.
Well, look at this side of the offensive line right here. All the big guys, you're gonna get a couple pullers out in front. Center and guard, great job finding their guys down the field. And then Kel Moore, patient on the outside, let the block set up for him, and then take advantage with a big run.
Anthony Palomares, the left guard, Sean Kreps, the center. And now, first and goal for the 5. Kelton Moore in motion. Ganji, corner throw, caught, touchdown, that's Mannix.
Yeah, that's a great throw right there. One-on-one coverage. He recognizes the defense. And we talk about it. Mannix and Fossum, very talented guys in the slot. It's just an easy corner route. You're going to high-low the corner. And Mannix does a great job getting on top, get a little move at the top of his route, and wide open in the back corner to get 6 points on the board.
Great touch on that touchdown. Of course, great touch on the throw to Romeo Dubs that really unlocked that drive. Ahmed for the extra point, and in this rivalry game, Nevada on the road and on top. Ty Ganji is sharp, and it's 7-0. Thanksgiving weekend in Las Vegas. 7-0, Nevada on top of UNLV. Let's head down to A.J. Ross. A.J.?
Hey there, Rich. You guys touched on this record stats. All that goes completely out the window when these two teams compete for the Fremont Cannon. We're talking about pride, tradition on the line. This rivalry dates back to 1969. Let's take a look at the Go RVing road trip back. Tonight is the 44th time, I should say. Nevada and UNLV have met for this rivalry matchup, competing for the largest and most expensive rivalry trophy. The Fremont Cannon weighs roughly 545 pounds and cost around $10,000 to build 40 years ago. Now, the winner of tonight's matchup will get to hold the cannon until next year and paint it their school's colors.
AJ, that's impressive. That's the biggest rivalry trophy going in college football. The Fremont Cannon. UNLV. Evan Owens, good coverage there by Nevada. Aaron Murray put a pen to paper and came up with his keys to the game. What you got?
And we talked about for UNLV to start the show off, create some kind of explosive play down the field. This isn't a defense in Nevada you can just continue chop away at. And then defensively for Nevada, can you contain Armani Rogers, force him to be a pocket quarterback tonight?
The wrinkle here for UNLV, obviously they need to get it done on the ground with Rogers and Lexington Thomas, but Nevada's been very good lately against the run, and this is Thomas with nowhere to go. Yeah, he's blasted right about the 17-yard line. The market at the 18, Malik Reed and Gabe Sewell made the stop.
No, it's a very talented defense, first off, but when you know the ball is going to get run, the safeties are downhill, the linebackers are downhill, they're filling in the gaps fast. At some point, you got to utilize the play action pass and maybe take a shot down the field.
Look at the improvement there in the last three seasons. Quick pop there. It's caught by Presley trying to get outside. That looks like a face mask, and it is. Flag comes from way down the field. Presley with the catch. Nice run after the catch, and they're going to add 15 yards to this play.
Personal foul, face mask, number 23, defense. 15 yards to be added to the end of the run. Automatic first down.
Yeah, it's a great call by the ref right there. And those are actually the plays, talking with the coaching staff yesterday for UNLV. The quick hitters from Armani Rogers. They know he can throw it deep. He can throw the dagger route, 18-yard in route. He can throw the post ball. Can he throw a hitch? Can he throw a slant on time? That's something that he's been working on even while he was banged up middle of the season.
42-yard line. Rogers has a strong arm, flushed. This is where he's dangerous. Sore foot and all, midfield, up the sideline. Wow, he's moving well. Asani Rufus caught him. First down at the Nevada 42.
And this is when he's dangerous right here. When he gets through his reads, plenty of time in the pocket. Great job. And then when he takes off, and I tell you what, he's impressive to look at. He's big, tall, physical, long strides. And as a defense, you got to take proper angles right there. Not a great job by Nevada.
Fired outside, Presley with the catch, escapes one but not two, and he's brought down there by Asani Rufus. This is a good defensive secondary for Jeff Castile, the defensive coordinator for Nevada. Daniel Brown and Jamon Dotson on the corners, Baber and Rufus, and Nephi Sewell in the safety spots.
They're talented on the outside, and what I want to see, you're seeing a little bit off coverage from the corners. And you see a little bit more press. See if Armani can be more accurate against man coverage.
Lexington Thomas maybe one. Sam Hammond made the stop for Nevada.
And the key is Lexington Thomas, can he get going? And when you add Armani Rogers into the mix and hit the threat of him running, the threat of Armani Rogers throwing it deep down the field, it's going to give Lexington those opportunities we saw in the pregame, his ability to hit those 40, 50, 60-yard big play home runs.
Possibly four down territory here. It's third down and four. Rogers flushed and fires it too hard, overthrows Darren Woods. And now you're looking at fourth down and four. If you try a field goal here, you're looking at about a 50-yarder. And that might be a little bit out of the range of Evan Pantel's.
It's just a three-man rush right here.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Wow.
And I think that's clean. It was right at the waist. It wasn't below the waist on time. And I agree going for this right now. Let him go through his reads. Armani Rogers, go through his reads. Nothing there. And this is the benefit of having him at quarterback. He can get you four or five. Nothing's open. And it looks like Nevada's going to bring the pressure, though.
Blitz comes. Rogers in trouble. Firing the sideline. Overthrowing Presley. And it's incomplete. And fourth down and four turns into a Nevada ball.
And that's the man-to-man coverage on the outside that I want to see from this defense all night. Make Armani Rogers accurate down the football field. If you give him time, he can pick you apart. But great defense. These guys are doing a great job to start it off. Tight man-to-man coverage. One of the best defenses in the Mountain West.
College football on CBS Sports Network is sponsored by Verizon. Get the gift you want on the network you deserve. By Chick-fil-A Catering. It's the little things that take the stress out of the holidays. And by Go RVing. Find your way. Go RVing.
All right, a couple things here. That was Jay Norvell's running back group, and that was their Thanksgiving. And did you see the game they had on in the room there? That was the Thanksgiving game, Colorado State at Air Force. Catch there by McLean Mannix. Mannix, who caught the touchdown pass, has a gain of four right to the 40-yard line. All right, continuing our Chick-fil-A lineups offensively, Romeo Dubs has emerged as a weapon. He's just a freshman.
Yeah, and he's gained more and more confidence. First time he touched the ball this season, took it for a touchdown on a punt return, getting better and better these last couple games, 225 yards, a couple touchdowns, really coming into his own this season.
Little toss there, and Jackson Kincaid is hit and stopped at the 42-yard line. Bailey LaLonghi made the stop for UNLV. Now the Rebels defense has been a work in progress. Tim Skipper hoping that his group can get it rolling. Evan Austria in the strong safety spot, going to have a good night.
It's going to be both safeties, because we talk about this team offensively from Nevada, the air raid attack. It's a little bit of run, too. There's a lot more run involved than, say, Washington State. So they're going to have to be the eyes in the backfield, and then they got to cover Fossum. They got to cover Mannix, two of the most talented slot receivers in the Mountain West. It's a lot to ask for. Eye discipline is going to be the key for these safeties.
Toa Taua at running back. On his third down and four, Ganji with the blitz comes, dumps it off. Mannix, a juggling catch out across midfield. He's to the 40 and bounced out of bounds at the 37. McLean Mannix streaking across the middle and somehow found the handle on that.
That's a great job by Mannix. Find the seam, just a little shallow route. They're going to clear the left side of the field. Vertical routes by the receivers up top, and Mannix doing a great job. And for a quarterback, it's tough to see. Man, he's about 5'9". To be able to locate him only 3 yards, 4 yards behind the line of scrimmage is a tough task. That's why you saw the ball coming a little hot there.
That's why you have trouble locating me at times. Straight ahead, tumbling there. Toa Taua. Our Bud Light inside tracks. Last four games for Ganji.
Comfortable and healthy. The key is his health. Because you turn on the film, it's not just sitting in the pocket. We know we can do that. We've seen it so far tonight. But his ability to get outside the pocket, extend plays, it's also why you're seeing that accuracy right around the mid-60s.
Second down, five. Taua, the freshman, he has really taken things over. You know, we focus on Ganji in his last four games. How about this guy? Of course, his brother, Vi, was and still is a Wolfpack legend. But this freshman's had an enormous breakthrough.
And his role keeps getting bigger and bigger, too, as well. 29 carries last week. 29 carries. And we talk about this being an air raid attack. You think air raid, you think 50, 60 throws. But when you got a running back like this, big, strong, physical, to make guys miss, you're going to run the ball a little bit more.
Third down, two. Let's see if they run it here. Rebels will blitz. Ganji has to unload it. Fires it up, and it is just behind Elijah Cooks. And good pressure and a nice gamble by Tim Skipper, the defensive coordinator.
And Tim Skipper told us yesterday, you're going to see right here, look at all the guys blitzing. Skipper said, wait, we're not going to sit back and let them pick us apart. We're going to be the aggressors. We're going to come after this offense. We've seen it a couple of times with some cover zero blitzes, man blitzes. And I like this call right now. You got a big running back in the backfield. See if you can get him going downhill. Maybe even a play action, roll your quarterback out.
On fourth and two, Nevada has the lead in the empty backfield. And another blitz comes. Little dump pass caught there. Cole Turner, touchdown, Nevada. Yards. And this time, Ganji with the blitz coming unloaded early.
And once again, UNLV decides to turn up the heat on a fourth and short situation. And when you play man-to-man, you get all these crossing patterns. You see the defenders get mixed up a little bit. It's called natural picks. It's not design, it's just natural. When you have crossing routes and guys coming out of the backfield, defenders usually tend to trip over each other a little bit. And that's why you saw an open receiver for that touchdown.
not just an open receiver, an open receiver that had not caught a pass all year long until that one. Ty Ganji and Nevada, a fast start in this rivalry game. 14-0 start for the Wolfpack here in Las Vegas. Our top crew gets ready to, they may be waking up right now because 8 a.m. Eastern, they'll get you ready for another busy day in the NFL. That other pregame show right here on CBS Sports Network. Ty Ganji talking it over. He's got a real good group of talented wide receivers, a creative offensive coordinator, and Matt Mummy. And this Nevada football team is really humming right now.
Oh, it's full throttle. It starts with Matt Mummy, though, this offense. He's a great offensive coordinator, knows how to dissect these defenses and put together an awesome game plan.
Right now, if you're UNLV, you've been blown out a few times this year. And this is a rivalry game, and it looks like UNLV is going to pull the trigger on Max Gillum, who is the throwing quarterback. Much more of a thrower than Armani Rogers. And Gillum, the sophomore, is coming in.
This is a little interesting to me. I thought Armani had some really good moments those first couple of possessions, running the football, a couple good passes here and there, especially the quick hitches. I would much rather see get through the first quarter a little bit, get him into a groove. He really hasn't played a ton in the past couple months.
Gillum on a handoff. Thomas around the outside, shoved out of bounds. Nephi Sewell made the hit. Here's the comparison between the two. Now look, the record isn't great for Gillum. Hasn't had a great supporting cast.
He is the thrower of the two. I think Armani, you watch him in warm-ups. Armani definitely has more arm talent. It's just the accuracy, it's the timing with his feet that he needs to continue to work on. That's why you just want to get him more reps in games.
Gillum with a little pitch there. Xavier Campbell. And he's right at the 35-yard line. Now, look, you're right about Rodgers and maybe not being in game shape to play a whole game. Good lead option there. So we expected to see Gillum. I don't know that we expected to see him this early, but I think the Rebels planned to play Max in this ballgame. Blitz comes, dumps it off, caught there. Campbell again, cuts back, across the 40, but he is just shy of the first down.
And my, I guess, issue with the whole thing is Armani Rogers is your future. He's your guy going forward in this offseason into next season. And then what he missed this year, and the coaching staff told us yesterday, is reps. His ability to go out there and demonstrate that he can take that next step throwing the football. You take him out of game so early right now, he's not getting those opportunities to learn and to progress as a thrower.
Gillum on the handoff, Lexington Thomas, and Nevada's run defense has done a nice job of keeping Thomas bottled up, and that's not easy. And in his career here, Lexington Thomas has had some enormous games.
Well, you go to this defense, though, with the 3-3-5, you have the ability with a lot of DBs, a lot of speed on the field. So you see these guys, they're able to see, dissect it, see it's a run, and then boom, they're downhill in order to stop a speedy Lexington Thomas.
Campbell's back in there. Behind Gillum, who rolls to his left, fires Giovanni Fa'olo, the tight end, with the catch, and we rejoin A.J. Ross. A.J.?
Yeah, Rich, and speaking with offensive coordinator Barney Cotton, he says Armani and Max are actually friends. They've supported one another both on and off the field with Rogers recovering from that foot injury. And in fact, you might say they were destined to play with one another at one point, both committing to Cal before their journeys brought them here to UNLV.
Yeah, you're right, A.J., really ironic. You know, Gillum actually went to Cal, Rogers committed, they knew each other, and here they are sharing the duties in this rivalry game. Caleb Metter made the stop for Nevada, and that's going to be a loss of yardage. And it's third down and 9. What do you dial up if you're Barney Cotton?
First of all, you got to make sure you protect it, because right now Nevada, we've seen it this season, a ton of sacks on that side of the football, 31 sacks, and they're not doing it just blitzing 5-6 guys. They're getting pressure with 3 or 4 guys. So you got to first make sure, lock up at the line of scrimmage, and then make sure you cross that line of scrimmage to get the first down.
Three-man rush, and that little dump pass is in and out of the hands of Lexington Thomas. And as hot as Nevada's offense is, UNLV is going to have to give the ball back to them, down two scores early.
I think right there, Gillum felt the pressure a little bit. Didn't sack him, but just enough to make him a little bit uncomfortable in the pocket to get off his reads and having to get the ball checked down to his running back. Lexington Thomas would have had to make about three or four guys miss in order to get that first down.
Hayes Hicken. And it's going to take a kick back towards the playing field. And it's down right at the 21-yard line. Nevada's had two touches. They've got two touchdowns. It's 14-0.
It's awesome. It's like a state championship for us playing UNLV. You know, it's pretty awesome to be out here and experience this rivalry with them.
It just means a lot to me. I'm pretty sure it means a lot to the other guys on the team. And that can mean a lot to the city. That's one thing we're working on getting back.
It's the Fremont Cannon. You win the trophy, which is the largest rivalry trophy. You get to paint it your color.
Yeah, and both teams hoping for Nevada blue. UNLV, they want to paint it red. Right now, it's been a great start for Nevada so far offensively. Great first two possessions.
Kelton Moore in motion. Ganji fires it, finds Moore, has a blocker, but that play is blown up. Dalton Baker over there to make the play along with Demetrius Gibbs. Keys to the game on this side of the ball.
And right now we saw with the post route, a couple plays to slot receivers as well. Utilize the middle of the field with your slot receivers, Mannix and Fossum, and then defensively, you want to somehow make this Nevada team throw the ball the entire time. If you can keep them in third and long situations, that gives this defense the best way to have success.
Movement and contact. And a flag, and that's going against UNLV. Kulowaske, big nose tackle with the movement.
Defense offsides, number 54, defense. Jumped in the neutral zone, got a reaction for the offense. 5-yard penalty, ninth second down.
Waske is actually 94, but we don't have a 54 on that side of the ball, so I'm assuming it was him. There he is. The junior out of Mesa, Arizona. Toatawa in the game for Nevada. Another middle shot, another catch. Caleb Fossum. And Aaron Murray just re-emphasized, throw some balls over the middle, and they've had success already.
Well, it's the play action pass, and then they pull the guard on top of that. So you're going to see all the linebackers, all look at these guys up there. Biting on the play action, then it's easy pickings for a quarterback. Get up there, middle of the field's vacant, and you got a slot receiver run right across there for you. Nice and friendly, showing his numbers.
This is Tawa spinning, and he lands at the 48-yard line. Now, you and I saw Ty Ganji and Nevada against Boise State, and they darn near won that football game. He looks like a completely different quarterback tonight. He's healthy.
Well, it's tough with any kind of lower body injury. He had a thigh contusion middle of the season. So he's protecting it a little bit. And then we talk about his ability to run. It's his natural instinct. And when you take that part of a game out of him, it's a little tough just to sit back in the pocket. But he's doing a heck of a job so far tonight.
Play action fake, fires it deep and too deep. Mannix trying to fight through the traffic, got through there, but Ganji overshot him.
And that's funny, we were talking at the commercial about Ty Ganji and just giving his receivers an opportunity. We saw on the corner route for the touchdown, the post route to start the game, let your guys who are very talented go up there and catch it. The first inaccurate pass we've seen. Great job, great play design. They've run a couple screens so far this game to the outside to the receivers. Right there, you just got to put it right in his chest, let him catch it like a punt, and then get in the end zone for the touchdown.
Third down and four. Three-man front for UNLV. Little inside handoff there. Tawa with a flag down, has the first down into Rebel territory at the 46.
It looks like defensive offsides once again. So a free play, they took advantage of it, got the first down anyways.
Jay Norvell, his second season. 31 years as an assistant coach, both in college football and the NFL.
offsides, number 54, defense. That penalty is declined. The result of the play is first down.
That's the second time right there, right over the center.
That's Waske.
And a great job by the center right there, making sure he gets the ball snapped while he's still in the neutral zone.
Final minute, first quarter, Nevada's third drive. That one deflected and incomplete. Caleb Fossum was the intended receiver. Roger Mann, who plays that buck position for UNLV, got a hand on it.
That's a great job getting up there. They've seen enough of those passes to the slot receiver so far tonight. Great job disengaging from the tackle, getting his hands up there and tipping the ball.
Now UNLV has suffered through an awful defensive year, but the last couple weeks they've played much better. They're starting to force turnovers. They had two picks at Hawaii. They've got five turnovers, five picks in the last 3 weeks. So they've been able to make some plays, but not here. Big man going. Kelton Moore to the 10, to the house. Touchdown, Nevada. ...46 yards, and Nevada has scored on every possession here in the first quarter.
And it's a great job by the tight end. I want to see right over here. First off, offensive line doing a great job, and then a great kick out right there. To give his running back just enough room. That's number 48, 49, Trey Carter-Wells, doing a great job. Gotta love when you see a tight end getting in there, getting nasty, and open up a big gaping hole for his running back.
Extra point is no good. Big and gaping is apt, not only for this hole, but for this lead. And Kelton Moore goes the distance. Nevada, a 3-touchdown lead. We told you at the outset, Nevada is hot. They've won 4 straight. It's their longest win streak since 2012. We didn't know they were this hot. 3 possessions, 3 touchdowns, 3 long drives. And right now, a 20-0 lead.
Well, sometimes, and we mentioned it with Tim Skipper, defense coordinator for UNLV, said he was going to bring the heat defensively. Sometimes when you bring too many guys, yeah, they're going to hit some big home runs on you. And we've seen that so far in those first 3 possessions.
It's like Max Gillum's going to get another drive here. First 3 possessions. Look at this, Aaron Murray.
And then look at the time, too. 118, 311, and then 46 seconds. It's the big post. It's the corner. It's the big runs. The offense line doing a great job up front, run protecting and then pass protecting as well.
Armani Rogers started at quarterback. This is Gillum bouncing it outside, losing the football. Still on the turf. Still loose. And Nevada's got it. What a disastrous first quarter for UNLV. Nephi Sewell recovers, and the Rebels can't do anything right.
I think Gillum just got a little excited right there. Tries to change hands. Obviously, you want the ball in your left hand if you're going to the left. But not being as natural of a runner as a running back is, or receiver, kind of fumbles it there as he's making a switch. Sometimes you just got to hold on to it if you're Gillum. But Jay Norvell has to feel good about that. Offense is rolling, and you get a great turnover. And once again, inside the 20-yard line, have all the momentum on your side.
And inside the Verizon red zone, you see Nevada right around national average. 63% of the time, they stick it in the end zone. 100% of the time tonight. Blitz, Ganji throw, little center screen in the middle there. And that's Trey Carter-Wells, who, as you described, had a great block on that last touchdown run by Kelton Moore. No gain on the play. And second down and 10. Gillum on a headset right now as UNLV searching for answers. Gillum has had 2 series. And Armani Rogers has had 2 series as well. Second down, 10. Firing it out to the outside, ball's loose. It was incomplete. not a lateral. McLean Mannix couldn't hold it. Dalton Baker made the hit. Third down and 10 when we get back. What a start in this rivalry game. The Wolfpack of Nevada rolling on the road. Brent Stover, thank you for that. We kept an eye on that USC Notre Dame game, and we'll keep you up to speed as well as the night goes along. Some really good ball games still to come. Nevada with a football and an enormous lead right now, 20-0, starting the second quarter. Ty Ganji has been brilliant. The defense of Nevada has been outstanding, and that's a 6-yard carry there.
This is interesting right now. We talk about rivalry games. I thought for a second they may have gone for it on fourth down. But good job right there. UNLV get put in a bad situation. Bad first three series. Offense turns it over inside the red zone. And they hold strong right there.
You can see it does get a little windy out here in the desert. And this stadium is out in the desert. It's away from the strip. About a 20-minute drive from the UNLV campus. It's 29-yard attempts by Ramiz Ahmed, the senior. And Ahmed knocks it through. Well, the first three scores were long drives, but the fumble by Max Gillum opened the door for three more. And the Rebels will get the football back when we return. It's a new league, and it offers new opportunities. And Tuesday night, right here in Las Vegas, 8 Eastern, CBS Sports Network is live. It's the inaugural Alliance of American Football quarterback draft. Franchises will select who will lead their teams under center. And you know what? This is the site of the championship game. Aaron Murray, who may be the first guy selected in that draft, just down on the field. What were you daydreaming about?
I was mean mugging there. I didn't look at, no, I looked so scary. My mom's like, always smile. Why are you always angry? Spent a lot of money on those pearly whites.
So Atlanta has a team.
Yes.
It sounds like you may be running that team. Well, not running the team, but running the offense.
I'll be a GM and coach, you know? A little Jackie Moon action.
And this is the site of the championship game. There will not be a franchise here, but the championship game will be played right here.
And like you said, come Tuesday is going to be the quarterback draft. All these teams get the pick, so fingers crossed. Hopefully Atlanta picks me.
And in all honesty, when I checked into the hotel the other night, they said, Mr. Stover, welcome.
Stover.
Because Brent Stover will be here and he will be hosting. So Brent,
Mr. Hollywood himself.
Your suite is ready. We did not touch the fruit basket, promise. Armani Rogers back in at quarterback and throws a dart over the middle, and it's caught there by Makai Stevenson, and a flag comes flying in the defensive backfield well after the play was over. So Rogers is back in after two series with Max Gillum, and maybe UNLV has found an offensive spark. It's a 20-yard throw.
And it's going to be head-to-head contact right here on Damian Baber.
Personal foul, targeting number 5 defense, leading with the crown of the helmet. 15-yard penalty be added to the end of the run. Automatic first down. Previous plays under further review.
Well, here's the review.
Yeah, and right there, yeah, you see clearly helmet-to-helmet contact right there. Damian Baber lowers the crown of his head, runs it right up Stevenson's as well. So this should be a quick. You see right here, 15-yard penalty. He will miss the rest of this game. He will be eligible to play to start the bowl game, but will be out if this play is upheld.
Well, they're reviewing it right now.
Right, you see crown and a helmet. Then you want to keep, as a defender, square up, face up. It protects not only the offensive player, but it protects you. You don't want to put your head down and get that contact yourself. It's not safe for anyone. And we've seen a lot of these penalties called. These kids and these coaches can need to continue working on proper form and proper technique in the offseason. Right there, a little head-to-head.
After further review, the ruling on the field is confirmed. Number 5 is ejected from the game.
And so Baber is ejected from the game. There's a disqualification rules. If it's in the first half, the DQ is only for the rest of the game. And so.
Yeah, it's unfortunate because he's one of the best players on that defense. He's all over the field. You turn it on. That's the first thing I asked the coaching staff is tell me a little bit more about this player. He is all over the place. They will miss him for the rest of this ball game.
You see his season 3 interceptions, 12 interceptions in his career.
And it's senior night too, which is unfortunate for him.
Shotgun and Lexington Thomas on the left side.
Well, going back to that previous play, Armani Rogers, we talked about at the start of the show, if he can throw the football, he just needs the opportunity to play a full game. I mean, it's been a couple months since he's been able to play all 4 quarters and be able to demonstrate that, hey, I am a different quarterback. Yes, I can run, but I can make throws just like that. I think he's been very accurate so far tonight. He just needs more opportunities.
Second down and 7, Rogers to carry it, and he's swallowed up. 3 Nevada players there to get him. Caleb Metter and Jarius McDade, no gain on the play.
Well, look at this ball. You see right here, tall, big hands, great delivery, and threw an absolute dart right in the money, right in the chest of his receiver, Stevenson. It's not the throws 15 to 20 yards or even the post routes or go balls. It's more of the slants, the quick outs, the hitches he needs to continue to work on. But I said that just comes with more repetition.
Has time, another middle shot, and that's a collision right as the ball arrived. Makai Stevenson was the intended receiver.
And I think this is fourth down territory right here. I think you've crossed the 50, you crossed the 40. I would have more liked to see that previous play, maybe a run, knowing that you're going to go for it on fourth down right here.
So now a fourth down and 8. 23-0, Nevada. Rogers in trouble, escapes. And he has Thomas, makes the catch, makes a move into the end zone. What a throw by Armani Rogers.
And that's what that young man can do right there. He can escape, he can extend the play. See him right here in the pocket, gets through his read, nothing's there, let me get out of the pocket. And you see the defense, the respect he gets as a runner. Everyone comes down, pulls it back, finds his talented running back for the touchdown. Great throw. That's a tough throw to make going to your left, too.
There are signs of life here in the desert for UNLV. Down 23-0.
There, you got to get a little taste of what Armani Rogers can do, running it, and a great throw to get his team on the board right there.
College football on CBS Sports Network is sponsored by Bud Light, reminding you not to drink and ride your horse. By Reese's Peanut Butter Cups. And by Sonic. Sonic presents the quarter pound double stack cheeseburger plus tots for only $2.99.
Some of the biggest moments this year in college football and our presentation on CBS Sports Network. And that last moment there, that was the Old Dominion's upset at number 13, Virginia Tech. 68 regular season games played. Still have the Conference USA Championship, couple bowl games as well. Here, 23-0, Nevada on top until UNLV on an acrobatic throw by Armani Rogers to Lexington Thomas.
And this is what he can do. Get through his reads, Armani Rogers. Big toe in the pocket, but right there, the thought of running. You see all the defenders, they lose sight of who they're going to be guarding, who they have in man and zone because of the threat of the run from the quarterback. And then Lexington Thomas doing a great job. And these coaches, they love it. They got their stud quarterback back there making plays for him early in this ballgame.
And we talked about Thomas, and remember, he was in a boot for 5 weeks, which meant he couldn't do anything, really, to keep himself in shape. So he's on the bike trying to stay warm. Back to work goes Ty Ganji. Back deep goes Ty Ganji. And that one's picked off. Intercepted. UNLV with a turnover. Jaquez Khalili, the senior corner and a local guy out of Las Vegas.
Same play they ran earlier, just a double post, one-on-one on the outside. Khalili doing a great job running the route, pretty much further receiver there. Beats him to the spot. You talk about a great last drive to put some points on the board. Now you get a turnover yourself on the defensive side. And that quarterback right there, Ty Ganji, has not thrown a lot of those these past four games. We talked about 8 touchdowns, 1 pick the last 4 games heading into tonight. He does a great job protecting it, but better defensive play there.
Rodgers hands it off. Thomas fighting for yards. Thomas is the type of back that will be stuffed for a quarter and then bust a 70-yarder. That's kind of what he's been in his career. He's 18 100-yard games and 40 career rushing touchdowns.
And we saw that for San Diego State. Their win right there. Lexington Thomas, that big run late in the game to get them that victory. It's just stay committed to the run. Stay committed, and all of a sudden, he can find a crease and take it for 70.
Yeah, that was a 75-yarder at San Diego State that really broke the Aztecs back late in that game. Lightning is hit, fights forward, and he's got the first down. Let's go to New York, Brent Stover. Thank you, Brent. There's the standings in the Mountain Division. Of course, Fresno State has come out of the West and will travel to meet either Boise State or Utah State in the Mountain West Championship game next week. All of a sudden, the Rebels, Evan Owens on the grounds with a nice carry there. That's a 9-yard pickup, and Armani Rogers has sparked this offense.
And that's why I'm scratching my head up here when they took him out after that second possession. Keep him in the game, keep him in a rhythm, get him going a little bit, the quarterback position. He can make plays like that, and then he just opens everything else up. The run game and then the pass game as well.
Second down and one. That was the first stop by UNLV's defense in the pick. Straight through, Owens. He's got a burst inside the 20 and down to the 19-yard line. And the Rebels are rolling.
I want you to take a look right now at the offensive line. Great job getting off on the snap right here, creating the hole. All 5 guys plus the tight end in rhythm. And then Evan Owens, we talk about Lexington Williams with that ability to hit the hole and go. That was impressive from number 29 right there to get the big play on the ground, but more credit to the big guys up front.
So they mark it at the 18, and you see the drive all on the ground, 54 yards of it. Rodgers to the corner, and it's over the head of Makai Stevenson. And let's check in with A.J. Ross. A.J.?
Hey there, Rich. After that huge interception by Jaquez Khalili, you could feel the palpable momentum shift on this UNLV sideline. Guys cleared the bench, coming over to dap him. He was posing for imaginary pictures here along the sideline. It definitely was a much-needed spark for the Rebels.
Boy, no kidding, A.J. They were down. The Rebels were 23-0 when they got to the second quarter. But they have dominated offensively here in the second. Rodgers open, caught, touchdown. Follow Giovanni. 18 yards.
Gotta love the play design. You see the both tight ends lined up to the right of your screen right there. Noah Bean clears it out, and Giovanni falls right behind. And that cover two zone, you take the safety out the first tight end. Number two comes right behind, wide open for the touchdown.
Remember, it started with a pick. Jaquez Khalili picks off Ty Ganji. 4 long runs, and then Rodgers to Faolo. The Rebels are back. Thanksgiving weekend in Las Vegas. Nevada's lead was 23-0. It's 23-14 right now. Verizon Halftime Report's coming up. Brent Stover, Houston Nutt, and Kevin Carter from our CBS Sports Network studio in New York for a look around college football. All kinds of stories in college football today. Big upsets, big wins, movers, shakers. That top 10 should have some movement as well. That's all coming up on the Verizon Halftime Report. Rich Waltz along with Aaron Murray and AJ Ross here in Las Vegas. First quarter was absolutely dominated by Nevada, but UNLV has owned the second quarter.
They have owned the second quarter. I think right now for Nevada in this offense, they just got to take a little bit break. They're taking some shots downfield. You see right there, the big post picked off with interception. Then UNLV taking advantage of it. And right now you get the ball back. He's still got the lead at 23-14. Get back to the run game a little bit. See if you can pound it out. Keep your defense on the bench for a little bit. Give those guys a breather. They've had a long second quarter. End of the first, chasing around Armani back there at quarterback.
Toa Tower is hit and dropped. Gabe McCoy came shooting through. The sophomore linebacker out of Pittsburgh, California. And all of a sudden, the momentum has gone from the offense to the defense. An interception and then a run-stopping play and a loss of two.
I think they've settled in a little bit more. Not as aggressive as we saw those first couple possessions. They're kind of sitting back and forcing Nevada's offense to earn every yard.
Kanji on second down and 13. Tower again smothered. Jameer Outsi and McCoy also in on that stop. And the Rebels emotional right now. This place was absolutely flat when Nevada came out and scored on their first four possessions.
It was funny talking to both the defensive and offensive coaches yesterday for this UNLV team. They said when Armani came back and when Armani's in the game, it gets everyone excited. That's their leader. That's their guy. He brings juice to this team offensively, and now you're seeing it on the defensive side.
Third down, 13. Little inside throw there. Romeo dubs the catch, trying to cut through the linebackers, and he's caught and stopped at the 26-yard line. It's a gain of maybe five, and there's another stop for this UNLV defense and a big shot of confidence you would expect.
Yeah, and hopefully with a good punt return here, get you a decent field position. Offensively, you're in the groove right now, and that's a dangerous thing when you have a quarterback like Armani, who's not only running the ball well and extending plays, but we've seen some tremendous passes too. So if I'm a defensive coordinator, I don't know what you do. Do you load the box up? You can throw it right out of your head as well.
This is the first punt for Nevada, and it's not a good one. It lands at midfield and rolls to the 43-yard line of UNLV. Nevada has the lead. UNLV has the momentum in a great rivalry in the Mountain West. Phillips 66 Athlete of the Week, Asani Rufus. And with more on that, here is AJ Ross.
That's right, Rich. An anchor in the Wolfpack secondary, Asani Rufus, suffered a devastating broken leg last November, making his return for his senior season questionable. With sheer grit and determination, he's not only persevered, he's playing at an elevated level, currently ranked third all-time in Nevada history with 326 tackles. Coach Norvell calls him a dedicated leader both on and off the field, and the intangibles he brings to this team can't be measured in stats alone.
All right, thank you, AJ. UNLV back to work, and Armani Rogers throws deep and incomplete. Asani Rufus, our Phillips 66 Student Athlete of the Week. Now, Nevada academically has been terrific this year. You see the total yardage. What a flip-flop from the first to the second quarter. This Wolfpack team, APR is the academic progress rate, which measures school student athletes. And you would expect at the top you'll find Northwestern and Duke and schools like that. Nevada is actually 10th on that list this year. Swing pass, it's Thomas. Out of the backfield it comes to the 45, tackled out of bounds at the 46. That's a gain of only three. Jay Norvell has done a really nice job on the field and in the classroom.
And that's one of his goals too. It's every head coach. is not only develop them on the football field, but in the classroom too. And Jay Norvell has done a great job already. It's year two, and we're talking about this team having possibly 8 wins this season, going to a great bowl game, having a chance to get 9 wins. They're buying in both on the field and in the classroom.
Yeah, 3 wins last year. Rodgers will tuck it and go. And the big man spun off his feet, crash landing at the 48. Don Peterson with the hit. He is short of the first down.
It's a great job right here. You love when the quarterback, he keeps his eyes down the field. That's the most important thing, because if you tuck it and run right away, that's when the defense is going to come up just enough to try to get close. A little surprised. I thought with a big quarterback able to run, you cross the 50-yard line, you got some momentum on your side. I could have seen those guys going for it on fourth down.
Hayes Hicken, the transfer from Utah. Caleb Fossen is going to watch this one land at the 5 and kick into the end zone. It's a 49-yard punt. So it's a big turnaround, and they can add to this win total with a game here tonight and a bowl game to follow. But these are some of the teams that have made a really sharp U-turn in the right direction this year.
And these bottom three right here, all Mountain West teams. I mean, this is a very talented conference. You got great ball by those three, and then you got the Fresnos, you got the San Diego States. But what he's done in year two, we talk about buying in, the players buy in to what he's preaching, offensively, defensively, taking care of yourself. And right now, he seems to have their ear.
So Nevada was stopped on downs their last drive. They threw a pick 2 possessions ago, and Farrell Hester, the sophomore linebacker, comes up along with Evan Austria to make the stop. It's a gain of 1.
And we talked about Austria to start this game off, about the safeties having a lot of responsibility, focusing on the slot receivers, the talented slot receivers, and then getting downhill to make tackles. That's a great job. Eyes in the right place and making a great tackle for a short gain.
What's changed about this offense for Nevada? Is it simply UNLV's defense is better?
I think UNLV right now is just making, you see right there, 3-man rush, making them earn everything.
And Ganji's throw incomplete. Dalen Hanley on the sideline, and he did not keep his feet in bounds. And it's going to be 3rd down.
You see that right foot, the toe on the line right there. When we talk about to start this game off, we're gonna see a good angle there. Yeah, the right foot was down. To start this game off, UNLV was a little bit aggressive. They wanted to be the aggressors. They got hit with some big home run plays. Right now, we've seen a couple times, just rushing 3 guys. Looks like they're gonna do it just again, once again now. Maybe even to just bring a 4th.
4 receivers, 3-man rush. Time for Ganji, flush to the right. Looking downfield, throws, and it's broken up. Diving play there. J.D. Alexander, the transfer from Arizona State, making the play.
May have gotten one away with one right there. Left arm kind of got caught behind the receiver, kind of tagged him. You see it right there. But great job defensively. Drop 8. Making Ty Ganji a little bit uncomfortable in the pocket. Can't find anyone downfield. Has to escape. And we got 8 defenders back there locking everyone down. Great job once again defensively.
After the jersey got straightened out, that was actually Bailey Lalonghi who made the play. That is a line drive kick. That's dangerous. It could hit a member of the UNLV team and be a fumble, but instead it's downed. Not a good kick at all. That didn't even get to midfield. Great field position for UNLV. 2 below average punts by Quentin Conaway.
It's just the rugby style. Let's see what happens. Lucky he didn't hit the guy protecting him right up front. Just a low line drive. I think he just kicked it a little bit low. And right now, once again, good field position. Like you said, Richard, UNLV, see if they can capitalize on it.
1st and 10. Thomas pitches it back. On a reverse, coming near side, Tyreek Collins cuts at the 30, avoids a tackle, spilled over the 20 to the 19-yard line. Little bit of trickery for UNLV.
little reverse right there, and you gotta love. Keep an eye on Armani right there. Number one, the quarterback gets lined up, and just enough going against a 6 foot, 290 pound defensive lineman. Not many quarterbacks can lock up a guy just long enough to get the receiver on the outside.
Rodgers gets a block from Thomas, heads to the edge, and gets out of bounds. He's a lot faster than he looks. I mean, he's 6'5". He's listed at 225.
It's the long strides. It's a long stride. This one's a little bit, I think, a little miscommunication between the quarterback and running back. How about Lexington right there? Throwing his shoulder in there as well. And he's not the biggest, 5'9", 170, but the coaches told us yesterday, Lexington Thomas, he's not scared to mix it up a little bit. He understands protections, and he can block for his quarterback there on the run as well.
Second down and four. Thomas straight ahead, and he's going to be well short of the first down, maybe a yard. Jarius McDade made the stop. And UNLV, who scored the last 14 points, with 4.5 left in this first half, faced with a third down and a long three, maybe four, deep in Nevada territory. Jay Norvell saw his offense score in their first four possessions, has watched UNLV put two touchdowns up since. Third down, three. On the ground, Campbell at the doorstep. Tyson Williams made the stop. First and goal, UNLV.
And when you're able to RPR, just a zone, simple zone read, defense is too hesitant, scared of the quarterback running.
Campbell again, and this time gets caught up at the line. Gabriel Sewell and Kyle Adams made the stop.
And Campbell, 5'11", 225. The running back you'll see most of the time in third and short situations. And then we get closer to the goal line right now as well.
I think Nevada wants to take a timeout. They do.
First timeout of the half.
30-second timeout. UNLV had brought a fullback in, Jamie Neal. And he was in there along with Campbell. Neal at 6'1", 270. Provides a lot of lead blocking from the backfield. We'll see if he stays in that package. There's a look at Tony Sanchez in his fourth year, the 44-year-old who had such an incredible run as a high school coach in this community at Bishop Gorman High School. In 6 years, he won six 4A state championships. He was a wide receiver in college at New Mexico State. And he took a big step forward last year. That's why this 3-8 for Sanchez, as he told us yesterday, was very disappointing. If they can get this game, if they can knock off Nevada, that would salvage it somewhat.
And a lot of excitement in the program. New facility, obviously the stadium being built for the Raiders that will be shared with UNLV. Raised a lot of money, a lot of cool stuff going on right now.
And you see Neal is in there, quarterback sneak, Rodgers. And he's in, touchdown. And the fullback, Neal, wasn't the lead blocker, he was the lead pusher.
And it's a great job too, just a quick cadence. Defense isn't completely set, they're waiting for the quarterback to go blue 80, blue 80, set hut. He gets up on the quick, gets right in there, and then uses his 6'5 frame to push ahead. A little help from the fullback from behind him as well.
He's going to have a sore back tomorrow.
Yeah, you said it, Neal. 6'1", 270, probably one of the biggest fullbacks in the country. I think he was a little gentle, though. Didn't go in, didn't spear his quarterback with the helmet, used his hands, just a gentle nudge
to
get him in.
You don't
gentle.
Don't want to get targeting on your own guy.
No, that would be a first.
But look at this. This was 23-0 after a quarter, and this had all the earmarks of an absolute blowout. And UNLV is up off the canvas and has put three touchdowns up, and just like that, it is a two-point game.
It just makes me keep wanting to go back to those two possessions that Max Gillum was in there at quarterback. If you keep Rodgers in those two, who knows? I mean, this could be maybe a 28-23 game, but look what he's able to do right now at the quarterback position. Obviously, we know he can run. Look at those strides, being able to outrun the defense, and then the ability to then get the defense to suck up, not so fast, throw it over top to Thomas, and then most importantly, his development in the pocket, sitting in there, dissecting the defense. We've seen some very accurate throws down the field, and then using his 6'5 frame on that QB sneak on that last touchdown.
We told you one of the questions about Rodgers coming into the game would be his fitness. Would he be able to go an entire game? He's had that boot on, really hasn't had a chance to play a full game. He looks fresh right now.
And the scary thing is the coaches said he's still not 100% right now. He's still recovering. But I tell you what, he looks pretty darn close right now to being what we saw to start this season off.
Good kick there. Nevada's got it at the 25. New York's got it. Thank you, Brent. We are almost late second here, and we'll be headed back to Brent and the Verizon halftime report. Nevada with the football. Their 23-0 lead is almost all gone. Mannix with the catch, and he's bounced out of bounds. UNLV absolutely could not stop Nevada on their first three possessions. Three long touchdown drives that looked easy.
Yeah, they've done a great job, though, hunkering down, and momentum is real. It really is, especially in football. You get it on your side a little bit, your offense starts moving the football, you gain some confidence on defense, get a couple three and outs, get the interception. This defense is feeling great right now.
Second down and 9. Kelton Moore straight ahead. Moore has a touchdown run in the game, and he's got a first down here. Javen White brought him down for UNLV to the 37-yard line.
And that was an important drive in general for this offense, but that was a very important first down, because UNLV these past couple of series have been doing a great job. Sometimes all it takes is one first to get things rolling.
Ganji pulls it, fires it to the sideline, caught there by Fossum, and he just got the edge and tripped over the 45-yard line, it looked like. He lands at the 47, and that's where the first down stick is. He's got the first down.
And great blocking on the edge. If you're going to run these screens to the outside, these bubbles and swings, you have to have great blocking from your receivers. Unselfish for those guys protecting their inside slot guy.
Matt Mummy, the offensive coordinator, the son of Hal Mummy, the innovative and somewhat revolutionary head coach and offensive coordinator in college football. The air raid, the same stuff that Mike Leach runs, the same stuff that Texas Tech has been so good at. Well, Matt Mummy has brought this offense, and he says, look, we are an air raid team, but we want to be a balanced air raid team.
It really, you turn on Washington State, you watch those guys, they're throwing it 50, 60 times a game. This is a great mixture of a little bit of run and a little bit of pass as well.
That one just out of the hands of McLean Mannix, the sophomore wide receiver. It stops the clock on the incompletion, and it's third down and 7. 1:55 left in this half. UNLV has got all of their timeouts left. And if this is not a first down and the ball's on the ground and the clock isn't stopped, you'd expect UNLV maybe to call a timeout.
Yeah, I would too. Right now your offense is moving the ball. If you're able to call a timeout about 150 to 148, somewhere around there, you give your offense plenty of time with two timeouts to move down the field.
Kanji, three-man rush, lots of time, threads the needle, caught there by Fossum, right at the first down marker at the 42, and he's got the first down.
And the thing Matt Mummy told us about these slot receivers, they understand defense. You see right there, Fossum seeing the coverage. He knows it's drop eight, finds the window, and shows his numbers to his quarterback. Very friendly, but that's just smart play by Fossum right there in the slot.
Drew Techman made the stop on that play for UNLV. Ganji again over the middle, caught by Mannix. He's got another first down, 13 more yards. Clock stops as they move the chains. Nevada has two timeouts, and on the move at UNLV territory.
And that's the same thing right there for Mannix. Understand, not running through the zone, but kind of throttling before the safety is very friendly for Ganji.
And now UNLV is going to call a timeout just to settle their defense down.
Well, and right now, this is a big drive defensively to hold Posse to a field goal to keep this to a 26-21 game. And maybe even right now for UNLV, we talked about the aggression with the play calling from Tim Skipper. This is the point where you may see a couple more blitzes to see if you can push Nevada out of field goal range and keep this to 23-21 game.
All right, Aaron Murray, record-setting quarterback at the University of Georgia. To my layman's eyes, the completions and the success for Nevada's passing game, deep balls in the first quarter. Here, it's been 10 to 15 yards over the middle.
But that's more their game. That's more of the air raid offense. It's not bombs away over and over. It's the throws about 7 to 12 yards. That's what the air raid offense is based out of.
First and 10. The 29 of UNLV. Ty Ganges, swing pass there. Kelton Moore racing to the sideline. And he's knocked down right at the 20-yard line. He's going to be a yard shy of a first down.
And that's where Ganges developed the most, I think, this season. And Jay Norvell knows it, is his ability to get through his reads. In years past, it's been 1-2 and maybe take off and use his legs. Right there, you see him 1-2 and then get down to his check down. He's back on a little swing route to get 9 yards.
Second down and one. Moore, great move. Hit there at the 11 and falls to the 9. Dalton Baker made the stop. Really a nifty move by the junior out of Arlington, Texas.
And nifty for a 240-pound back, too. There's a little bulldozer back there. But showing that he, along with that hammer, is a little swift, too.
Ball sits at the 10. Shotgun here. It's first and goal, and Ganges going nowhere. He's buried at the 8, and Nevada's going to call a timeout. Gabe McCoy was the first to get there.
I think right now,
Nevada, your second timeout of the half.
I think Jay Norvell right now understands the way UNLV's offense is rolling, the way his defense is playing. You need 7 points right now. And this is a completely different ball game. Got the confidence on UNLV's offense. 7 points. Get this to a 30-21 game. Get the momentum back on your side before this half ends.
What a roller coaster this first half has been. Let's check in with A.J. Ross. A.J.?
Hey there, guys. Coach Norvell was not happy with that last call. Kelton Moore has been driving, putting yards down, really getting close in the red zone here. So that's why he called that timeout, readjusting, and we'll see what play they develop here.
All right, thanks. Jay Norvell. Arizona State, Texas, Oklahoma, Nebraska, the Raiders, the Colts, all Big Ten defensive player for Hayden Fry at Iowa, coached under Barry Alvarez, Bob Stoops, Bill Snyder, finally getting his first chance as a head coach, leading an incredible turnaround for Nevada from 3 wins last year, 7 this year, looking for number 8 tonight in a rivalry game. Ganges end zone incomplete. Great coverage there. Elijah Cooks was the intended receiver. That's Evan Ostrey, the safety.
And they like Cooks inside the red zone. 6 touchdowns this season. And it's 6'4", 215. Ganges needs to put it on his body and make the DB run right through him.
There was a signal for a timeout. The Nevada bench started walking towards the field. Now the officials wave them back. No timeout. Third down and goal. 46 seconds left, first half.
We got Dubs. Looks like maybe one-on-one down here at the bottom of your screen.
Here comes a blitz. Ganges hit as he throws for the corner, and it's incomplete. Demetrius Gibbs on the coverage. And just as you pointed out, Aaron, Nevada's going to settle for a field goal try, and that's a huge win for the UNLV defense.
That's a big win right there.
Got a breeze in his face.
And he missed an extra point earlier, too. So I know this is a little farther away, about 5 or 6 yards farther. But this is an important kick to at least get this to a 26-21 game.
Ahmed knocks it through.
26-yard field goal by Ahmed is good.
Yeah, let's go back and look down at this play right here. Bring in the full-out blitz. You see everyone lined up, but I want you to focus down here. Once again, a crossing route versus cover zero. The cornerback gets a little messed up. As a quarterback, you're taught, you feel the pressure, cover zero. All you got to do is just retreat a little bit. Keep going, and then almost just lob it out there. Let your receiver come underneath that and catch it. Those crossing routes versus man and cover zero have been big plays. That time, Ty Gaines, you just missed it.
In a rivalry game, you saw Tony Sanchez. He watched Nevada race to a 23-0 lead in the first quarter. And then Nevada nearly lost that lead. UNLV ripped off three consecutive touchdowns. Nevada has a field goal. And with 36 seconds left before we hit Brent Stover in New York with the Verizon halftime report, it is a 5-point Wolfpack lead.
35-yard line. Follow the lead, Matthew.
Not a lot of time for Armani Rogers and the Rebel offense here.
And you also don't want to maybe force something down the field and give the ball back with some kind of silly turnover. I could see maybe a run right here from this offense. If you pop a 10-15 yarder off, then maybe burn a timeout or get going and then a 2-minute drill. The last thing you want to do is try forcing a deep pass and maybe cause a turnover.
He has the wind at his back, a blitz on the way, quarterback draw, and Rogers is tripped up. That's a heck of a play by Dom Peterson, the enormous defensive tackle, 6 feet, 315. And he just got a handout to knock over Rogers.
Yeah, that's kind of expected right there. See if you can reel off 10 plus yards to get going. But great half by both teams. Momentum going back and forth. This should be an exciting second half, Rich.
This is a nasty rivalry here, UNLV and Nevada. And man, was this a fun ride in the first half. From 23-0 Nevada to 26-21 at the half. After the break, we'll send you to our CBS Sports Network studio. For the Verizon Halftime Report, Brent Stover, Houston Nutt, Kevin Carter standing by. In Las Vegas, 26-21 Wolfpack.
We're watching the Verizon Halftime Report on CBS Sports Network.
Welcome inside our New York studios. Brent Stover, Houston Nutt, Kevin Carter, 26-21 at the break. Coach, your thoughts.
Nevada starts the game out 23-0. They think it's going to be a blowout, but no. UNLV comes back. About 20 unanswered points right there. Here's how it started. Watch the running back right here for Nevada. Kelton Moore, good job right here. Following his blocking, well blocked right here. He hits it. Outruns everybody to the end zone, but here comes UNLV. Now they come right back. Good job by Armani Rogers, avoiding the rush, moves to his left, finds Lexington Thomas, make a guy miss, tuck that ball away, get in the end zone, touchdown.
Armani Rogers, 6 of 11, 93 yards, 2 touchdowns. It's a 5-point game at the break.
In Las Vegas, Coors Light first half stats. A 23-0 start in the first quarter for Nevada, a great run in the second quarter for UNLV, and a 5-point game headed towards the third quarter. Rich Waltz along with Aaron Murray and A.J. Ross. What a roller coaster and an entertaining one it was in the first half.
It's been back and forth. It's been exciting. You talk about Nevada coming out very strong in that first quarter. UNLV finding their identity on offense, getting the interception, getting some great stops. Tremendous, tremendous first half. So we'll check out some of the highlights.
All right. Now, look, it was Nevada who owned the game to start with.
Oh, they did a tremendous job. Those first three possessions, big home run hits, feeling the pressure that UNLV was bringing defensively, taking advantage of it. And then UNLV, Armani started rolling a little bit, running the football. You see the defense coming up and then dumping off to his talented running back. Then most importantly, his ability in the pocket. Very accurate so far this game, has made some tremendous throws. It's going to turn into an entertaining second half now.
Now, significant that the ball is being held on the tee. During halftime, while we were away, the wind has really, really kicked up here in the desert. I mean, it's probably up 25. Look at this kickoff just stall in the air. The wind is probably at 25, 30 miles an hour right now. And that kick goes out of bounds. Nevada gets the first possession.
Kick out of bounds. Kicking team. Ball in place at the 35-yard line. First down.
And we check in with A.J. Ross.
Hey there, Rich. When I spoke with Nevada coach Jay Norvell about the huge momentum shift in this game, he says they just need to execute better offensively. He said they missed some blocks. He also mentioned the wind. You were just mentioning it. They've had to make some adjustments. And on defense, they just got to stick to the fundamentals. Meanwhile, UNLV coach Sanchez says once they managed to settle down their defense, everything shifted in their favor. And offensively, you can expect to see Armani Rogers under center the rest of this game.
All right, good stuff there, A.J. That's Kelton Morrow over the left side, and that starts the second half. Nevada with the first possession. They scored on their first four possessions, three touchdowns and a field goal. For Jay Norvell's offense ran into some trouble. UNLV's offense got going, and UNLV's defense made some big plays in that second quarter. Moore. And down he goes at the 30, or rather the 41-yard line. It's a gain of three, third down and about four. Aaron Murray, what difference does this win make to both quarterbacks?
It's definitely tough. Obviously, more advantage towards Armani just because he can run the football. So I think this really won't affect him. We've seen him throw it. I think he has plenty of arm strength to cut through the wind. And I think the same's true with Ty Ganji. He can move around a little bit too, but don't expect too many deep balls today. If this thing gets stuck up there in the air, it's gonna start to wobble a little bit.
Ganji's throw caught there, right in Rebel territory. Elijah Cooks cutting across the middle. That's the soft spot, at least lately.
It's a great job right off the defender's ear right there, right off the linebacker's ear, just a quick slant. But more throws like that, we talk about the wind. Slants, hitches, quick outs.
It was a 13-yard gain for Nevada. Ganji back to work. And that little screen there, McLean Mannix. Now the wind is at the back of Nevada and at the back of Ganji.
Well, you could see on that throw there. He's been very accurate on those bubbles and swing routes. And the ball kind of tailed on him just at the end right there and dove into the ground. A little low for Mannix to catch it. But, I mean, that's a lot of gust right there. The key for a quarterback, you have to throw a spiral. Because as soon as you throw any kind of wobbler or any kind of duck, the wind's going to catch it and kill it right in the air.
Second down and 10. From the Rebel 45, busting through is Toa Taua. And he got to the 43. That's a gain of three. This is going to be third down and about six.
And both offenses ran it very effectively in that first half. UNLV 143 and Nevada about 129 in that first half. So both teams are established in the line of scrimmage. And right now I can see if they get this to a third or fourth and manageable, they would most likely go for it. So a run is not out of the question here.
Boy, the wind seemingly getting stronger right now. And on third down, there's the quick pop. Did Mannix hold it? No, he didn't. It hit the turf, and McLean Mannix couldn't hold on. And Nevada now, let's see what they do. The football sits at the 42. And there's the bounce. And right now, Nevada's going to leave their offense on the field and go for it on fourth down.
I like the decision here. Would have much preferred just to hand it off there and get to that fourth and short situation. But still look for the slot receivers here. These guys do a great job in these third and fourth and about medium situations, finding the hole inside the defense.
Ganji sets, throws in traffic. And incomplete. Jacquez Khalili, who had the interception in the first half, makes the play.
And great job. You see right there, everyone's locked up. Khalili, tremendous job right on top of his guy. And once again, UNLV coming out to start this half, playing great defense. Get their offense the ball back.
Uh-huh. Chick-fil-A fan cam. What happened to our 70-degree sunshine in Las Vegas today? It is downright chilly right now.
Yeah, I just want everyone to know, up in the booth right now, you see all the Colt fans, but Rich pulls out his sweatshirt, getting a little soft on me up here. But hey, good for you. You looked ahead to the weather. It's just like the rest of these fans. I did not.
It's called preparation.
Yes, I was not prepared. I thought it was going to be a beautiful night. Still is. Might make it a little bit more difficult for these quarterbacks, though.
All right, first touch for UNLV. This is Xavier Campbell, and he's upended at the 47-yard line. Armani Rogers got the start, played two series, and then was pulled for a couple series, came back with a vengeance, and led UNLV on three touchdown drives.
And the stats are tremendous. Throwing the football down the field, we saw deep cross routes. We saw the seam route to his tight end for the touchdown, and then utilizing his legs. I'm telling you what, he gets everyone excited on that football team.
Lexington Thomas. He has yet to break a run, though he did have that nifty catch and run for a touchdown. Barney Cotton on the bottom there. In his fourth year as the offensive coordinator, longtime assistant at Nebraska, Iowa State, was an offensive lineman for Tom Osborne at Nebraska.
And right now going forward with Armani Rogers being told that he is going to be the quarterback for the rest of this game, he should feel some confidence now. A little stamp of approval from the coaching staff. His teammates are excited. And let's see if he can go out there and win it.
See how he handles the win. Thomas is in trouble, makes the catch. And a terrific job by Malik Reed, who is an absolute playmaker. Was a defensive end, was first team Mountain West Conference, and switched to linebacker this year.
Look at the throw right here, though. You get it up in the air, and a little bit behind from our angle up here at the booth, the ball started to tail to the right a little bit, the way the wind is going. So as a quarterback, you have to make sure you drive it through your target. Now, obviously, like we said, make sure it's spinning, so that way it's able to cut through that wind. It should be very interesting, too, for these punters going forward, especially punting in this direction.
Clean snap, and that's the perfect type of punt in this wind. There's a low-line drive. Oh, ball's loose. Did it get tipped? It's picked up by UNLV. Officials say it was not touched by a Nevada player. That was really close. That was nearly a disaster for Nevada. On a windy night now in Las Vegas. Whoa, that was close. CBS Super Bowl season continues tomorrow. A doubleheader. You start with Patriots and Jets, and you top it off with Steelers in Denver to take on the Broncos. And the day kicks off with NFL Today, presented by Jeep at 12 Eastern. Aaron Murray, your Chiefs.
Chiefs
at 9-2.
That was a fun game against the Rams there Monday night. That team with Mahomes back there at quarterback, Tyreek, all those talented. Andy Reid's really showing off what he can do as an offensive coordinator.
Boy, what a hit there by Bailey Lalonghi, the senior out of Folsom, California. Ganji started out hot and had some big hits for a couple of touchdowns, but since then the defense has been better, and now he's battling some wind here in Las Vegas.
Yeah, so you're going to see tighter coverage by the DBs, and then a little bit more downhill from the safeties too, and run support, knowing the ball pretty much can't travel too far down the field.
Ganji fires it, and it's incomplete. Windy here, but not windy in New York. Brent Stover with this update. All right, thank you, Brent. Aaron Murray, who you like in that ball game? Utah State, Boise State.
It's a fun game so far. Boise State, if Rippon continues to play well, he's a dynamic quarterback, and it's a third and fourth quarter. It's going to be tough to beat those guys on that blue turf.
They're down at 10. Movement and flags. UNLV twice early jumped off sides in situations like this. But Trey Carter-Wells.
Ball start. Number 39 offense. 5-yard penalty. Remain third down.
Wells is number 49, but I believe he was the culprit.
Well, you said it. In the first half, Ganji did a great job utilizing the cadence, get the defense to jump. This time he got his own guy. Did you see the quick little flinch right there for number 49, Carter Wells? And with this wind, I wouldn't expect them to try to get it all through the air right now. Maybe a quick pass somewhere around 12 yards, 10 yards, and then see if the receiver can get some yards after catch afterwards in order to get the first.
Third down, 15. Henley in motion. Ganji, little swing pass, and there's nothing there. Toa trying to create, and he almost gets the first down out of sheer will and strength. Now, he's a tough guy to bring down. The freshman goes 5'8", 205, but he's short of the first down. They mark it at the 31, 13 yards on the catch and run. And Jay Norvell in Nevada going to have to punt the football. And this third quarter is shaping up to be nothing like the first half, which was all offense. First quarter was all Nevada. Second quarter was pretty much all UNLV. No rugby style run up to this punt. That's a boomer and a great bounce. Look at that. Collins will pick it up. He's in trouble, escapes, and then is wiped out at the 13-yard line. Great rivalry in the Mountain West. Nevada on the road at UNLV. Thanksgiving weekend in Las Vegas. Rivalry in the Mountain West. Nevada and UNLV. They battle over the Fremont Cannon. We've got a national championship to be decided on CBS Sports Network on Thursday at 8 Eastern. Junior College National Championship. East Mississippi and Garden City, Kansas, on the 24-hour home of CBS Sports. Here in the Mountain West, Armani Rogers and UNLV deep in their own territory, looking for some breathing room. Sam Hammond is there to make the stop. Rogers, the sophomore who had a fracture of his foot, he missed a good chunk of this season. After making four starts, he played last week, didn't start. He did start this game.
And the key right now is get at least one first down. We keep talking about the wind. The wind's going to be in your punter's face, so you don't want to give Nevada good field position.
Rogers throws. That's a quick pop there. That's caught by Keys to the, let's see, a 22-yard line, and he's going to be short of the first down by about a yard.
We've seen that's probably the third quick hitch we've seen. That's what the coaching staff wanted to see improvement from, is getting the ball out of Armani's hands with tempo and with speed. He's executed that.
Look at this. Did you see Gabriel Sewell, the middle linebacker? Instead of going low, he went high. And he kind of crowd surfed on that quarterback sneak. And let's see where they mark this thing. He had to get just across the 23.
Yeah, I think he's going to be just a hair short. It's going to be close, though.
That's a measurement. Now, this is usually reserved for concerts here when you crowd surf, right?
Yeah, it's soul number 7 right there. You see him jump up there. Actually knocks Armani just enough to knock him to the right a little bit to slow his momentum. But this is big for this defense. If they're able to get a 3-and-out, like we said, with this win, their offense should get good field position with most likely not a great punt.
Whoa! He got it. Just enough.
So what pays them. He got a 6'5 quarterback, QB sneaks from 1 yard. And going back to last week's game, versus Hawaii, those are the situations that Bardenkind wanted to get better at. 3rd-and-1, 4th-and-1, did not have any success in the second half. And that's one of the reasons why they lost that game versus Hawaii.
And that's a game that the Rebels told us yesterday they really should have won. Inside screen there, caught by a spinning Drew Techman. That's his first catch. We have seen Drew Techman on offense. He's been playing safety, and we've seen him on special teams tonight.
Yeah, the coaches love him. I mean, you're going to see him mostly on offense, but defensively, he played DB in high school. They love him out there in coverage, especially with all the receivers that we see for Nevada. They like him matched up one-on-one. And like you said, too, you'll see him out there in special teams, punt return and kick return.
He had an interception in that Hawaii game. This is Campbell, and Campbell's loose to the 40. He's 50. He is in the Nevada territory and down to the 41. Nephi Sewell and his brother Gabriel hauled him down.
It's a great job blocking up front. Look at the right side of the offensive line. Pretty much elephants on parade right there. Sidikosa, the center, does a great job reach blocking. And then the running back does it the rest right there. Those are the explosive plays that Barney Cotton wanted to see from his offense tonight.
Did you just drop a Dumbo reference of elephants on parade?
Elephants on parade. The five big guys up front, get them going in one direction, that zone blocking scheme, which they love to do.
You saw Gabriel Sewell holding that right arm, the starting middle linebacker, the leading tackler for Nevada, is off the field right now as they tend to him. And there's Gabriel. His brother Nephi is one of the safeties. They've got another brother, Penne, as you see one of the Rebels being helped off. Penne Sewell had a fabulous year on the offensive line for the Oregon Ducks. And they've got a fourth brother, as you see Jacobson on his way off. There's a fourth Sewell brother coming to a college football team near you. First and 10 from the 41. Not much there for Lexington. Thomas bounces outside, and a good second effort. Nephi Sewell made the stop. It's a gain of one.
And that's the area when you watch the running game for UNLV. They've had some big pops when they do the zone inside, so between the guard and center, the guard and tackle. But really the big plays, like we saw the previous one, is when they get all those guys, Rich's favorite new phrase, elephants on parade going in one direction, the outside zone, the stretch play. They've hit some big ones so far this season.
Shotgun, Rogers rolling, fires down the field. Terrific catch, Makai Stevenson right at the 20. And he took a hit and held on.
For all those who say that Armani Rogers can't throw, look at this throw to his left on the run, about 15 yards, went in his face and puts it right on his receiver's face mask. That's a great throw and great concentration by Stevenson on the outside to haul it in.
19 yards on the completion, 21-yard line of Nevada. UNLV down five on the move, 6.5 left, third quarter. Rogers will pull it and keep it and pay for it with a hit right at the 16-yard line. Holds the ball, gain of five, second and five. Our red zone is brought to you by Verizon. Two trips, two touchdowns. That's pretty good. Campbell outside to the five, and he loops and is met in midair by Daniel Brown. Comes down at the 3-yard line, and it's going to be first and goal for UNLV.
Campbell trying to make the highlight film, trying to hurdle someone, but that's that outside stretch run play we just talked about. The offensive line, watch the offensive line, keep their shoulders square to the line of scrimmage. They do a great job gaining leverage on the defensive line. And then Campbell at 225, thinking he's about 190, trying to hurl the defender.
Well, high snap, Campbell again, right side, and he is stuffed. And thank goodness Armani Rogers is 6'5" and a great athlete. Watch this snap. This could have been a disaster for UNLV. I mean, the snap was an absolute bullet.
He's a great athlete, and using that 6'5 frame, but this is where, too, everything's in play right now. You got a quarterback sneak option at second and one, and then you get some of your big running backs in there, and then Jamal Neal, too. But look at this great reaction, great catching it.
Rogers rolling, man open, caught, touchdown. Noah Bean.
I think Nevada was thinking what I was thinking. Second and one, they're gonna run it. Quarterback sneak, they bring the fullback in there, Jamal Neal. Everyone's downhill defensively. And then a great play action and a great call by Barney Cullen. The play action, get Noah Bean on just a simple drag route going from left to right, and then an accurate pass from Armani Rogers. But great job. I got to give credit to Barney Cullen on that call right there.
Third touchdown throw. Armani Rogers and UNLV down 23-0 in the first quarter have come all the way back. And in this rivalry game in the Mountain West, UNLV has their first lead. Impressive stuff from UNLV.
Yeah, and great play call right here to get to that 28-26. I want you to see the tight end right here, and then these linebackers and how far they dive into the play action. And then Noah Bean, number 46, sneaks out behind, but you continue to run. And then look at the coaches, they're pumped. Barney Cullen right there in the bottom, raising the two hands for the touchdown. Great play design, second and one. A little play action bootleg to get this lead for UNLV.
Henley with a fair catch at the two, and they'll bring it out to the 25. Let's take a look at our quarterback comparison, and it's brought to you by Sonic.
The completion percentage right now for Armani Rogers, 10 of 15, three touchdowns, no picks. He's running the ball well. And for Ty Ganji, start off the game out, we saw it up and down the field, this offense. They really have not been clicking these past two quarters. We'll see if he can get the lead back for him on this drive right now.
So now Ty Ganji and the Wolfpack, you see the first quarter, it was 20-0, 23-0 before UNLV finally scored. And they've outscored Nevada 28-3-6, and another great play by the defense. Jericho Flowers, the junior corner, coming up. That is no gain on the play, second down and 10.
And it's been a great job by Tim Skipper, too, with this defense, kind of mixing it up, playing a little bit farther off, keeping everything in front. And he's excited about this group. He said, I wish we were healthier all year, and I wish we had more games, because they're buying in, they're playing better, and we're seeing it right now.
Little swing there. Caleb Fossum is caught. Yesterday, Tony Sanchez told us that his team learned a very painful lesson in Hawaii. They outplayed Hawaii on the islands for three quarters and did not finish. Didn't know how to finish. Right now, they are playing like a team that is determined to finish.
And they got a lot to play for tonight. Senior night, big rivalry, play for the big cannon. Home crowd right now is feeling juiced. And you got your quarterback back as well. It's a lot of things to be excited about tonight.
Third down and 10, Ganji and a shotgun.
Looks like they're gonna drop eight once again defensively.
Drop play, and that is Kelton Moore, who is short of the first down by a yard and a half. Jacquez Kalili, who's made some big plays tonight with the stop for UNLV.
It's been tough sledding past few drives or ever since pretty much the end of the first quarter. We saw the stat about the score. Right now, this offense needs to find some rhythm. They need to get going once again running. If this UNLV defense wants to continue to play off and soft, quick hitches, the run game, those are the things that are going to need to get going.
Wobbly kick, Collins gets out of the way, and it's going to roll inside the 20 all the way to the 16-yard line. Four touchdowns for UNLV, and Armani Rogers' fingerprints are on all four.
He's doing it all right now, very confident, throwing the football, moving around the pocket, keeping his eyes downfield is the key, always staying a quarterback. And then in the pocket, we saw 10 of 15, three touchdowns. And then the bootleg for the touchdown to get this lead to 28-26.
He was out since September 22nd, came back last week, played at Hawaii, limited play, eight carries, 31 yards, 5 of 15 through the air. But man, is he back tonight. The Rebels keep it on the ground, gonna gain a couple there. Lexington Thomas brought down by Nephi Sewell.
You can just feel the energy. You can feel the energy on the sideline. Defensive guys are watching in to see what he can do. Talking with the coaching staff yesterday, they're excited to have their QB back. I mean, he is the leader of this team, and he's an incredible playmaker. I know they only had 3 wins this year, but it's kind of crazy. If he was healthy all year, where this team could have been.
Flags down.
Ball start, number 72, offense. 5-yard penalty, main second down.
Hey, some good news for both teams. Remember, we saw Gabriel Sewell leave with what was a painful right arm or wrist. He is back in, and on that same play, Nathan Jacobson, the senior tackle out of Snohomish, Washington, he left on that play. He's back in as well, so that's good news for both. Second down at 13. Rogers is going to tuck it and not escape. Hausia Sakona, the junior out of Salt Lake City.
It's a great play call. I want you to see the corner up top. Just going to bring a blitz, which is going to cause the defensive line to stunt to the right. They're going to start mixing it up, bringing guys from different positions. And then a great tackle right there. But they just want to find any way possible to make Armani Rogers feel uncomfortable, whether it's running it or passing it for the rest of this ball game.
This is third down and 13 with a tricky crosswind. Rogers sets up, fires a bullet, deflected, and incomplete. In traffic, Darren Woods Jr., the intended receiver. And that's not a good sign. You see him limping on his way over to the sideline. You hope that foot is okay.
And it was a beautiful throw, though. I mean, he put that on an absolute rocket right there. Darren Woods needs to run through the route. You see a nice, cool, calm, and collective in the pocket. I thought that was an accurate ball. Receiver needs to run through the catch.
Into the wind. The punt is hung up. McLean Mannix, a great bounce and a great roll for UNLV. Down inside the Nevada 33-yard line. Keep it low and let it roll when you're kicking into the wind. And that ends up as a 54-yard punt. And now Nevada tries to get that first quarter magic back. If Nevada wins this football game, they'll go to 8-4 and 6-2 and be on their way to a bowl game and one of the best turnarounds in college football this year.
And we saw at the beginning of the show, +4 right now from last season. Love to get the +5 in the win column. It's going to start with Ty Ganji at quarterback.
Play action. Ganji's throw. Sideline caught there. Romeo Dubs. With a win tonight. 6 conference wins. They haven't done that since 2010, nor the 8 wins. They joined the Mountain West in 2012. Of course, that 2010 team was Colin Kaepernick and a bunch of NFL players on that team.
Oh, they had some studs back then. A lot of fun to watch. And this team's been a lot of fun to watch, too. This offense has been pretty exciting all season.
First and 10. Straight ahead. Toa Taua runs into Gabe McCoy. 2 yards for the game. You know, look, we've been talking about Nevada's offense and how good they were in the first quarter. But UNLV's defense was lost in that quarter, and so was their offense. And all of a sudden, the second quarter started, and everything changed. And here in the third, UNLV comes out, puts it in the end zone, and has their first lead of the game. Rivalry game, Mountain West Conference, UNLV up 2 after 3. Right, it's been Nevada, a 20-point first quarter, a 23-0 lead, and then UNLV off the canvas, and Armani Rogers took over, 28-26, going into the fourth. Jay Norvell's Wolfpack on the move, just outside their 45, second down and 8, handoff to Toa Taua, and the big fella rumbles inside Rebel territory to the 47-yard line.
That's a great block once again by Trey Carter-Wells, number 49, the tight end, pulling around, getting out front of his running back. But man, Rich, we've had a fun game. We thought at first this game would get out of hand. UNLV stepped it up offensively and defensively. Rivalry week, a lot of fun, a lot of emotion. We're talking to both coaching staffs, players. They want to win this game badly.
They're down three. A chilly night in Las Vegas. Hotawa is hit, forges ahead, picks up a couple. Roger Mann hauled him down. It's going to be fourth down and about a yard. And Mann just grabbed on and held on for the ride.
I think they're going to go for it. I would punt it right here, though. Push UNLV back, make them drive the distance. Hope your defense get a three and out, but they're going to get their big running back involved. See if they can pound out a first down. But you see UNLV, they're going to bring the pressure right now.
All lined up and ready to go. Ganji will keep it. Ganji is hit, falls for the first down. Ty Ganji, 6'2", 205.
Great job, great read, just a zone read. The defensive end wants to crash. Then once again, Trey Carter-Wells, number 49, on that backside block, just gets enough of the defensive end as he peels back to allow his quarterback to get the first down.
Kelton Moore now in the backfield on first and 10, 42-yard line of UNLV, play action. Ganji thinking deep, fires to the sideline. Mannix is there. The 20, stiff arm at the 18, ridden out of bounds. Big play for Nevada.
That's a great throw by Ganji. Mannix in the slot right here, just a little wheel route, but you see he understands, hey, I'm not going to beat my DB down the field. I got about a 5 to 7 yard cushion. Let me hold up, friendly for my quarterback. Doing a great job right there, understanding the defense.
18-yard line of UNLV. Nevada marching. Ganji, play action, and through it, he was looking for Elijah Cooks. And miscommunication between Ganji and Cooks.
Yeah, I think Cooks was running a slant. Ganji was expecting just a quick hitch off the RPO, run-pass option.
Is that a read by the receiver and the quarterback of a linebacker or a safety?
No, right there, it's pretty much the corners off, soft and off, about 6 yards. The quarterback wants to rip it and take the quick hitch he can. Just a little miscommunication, maybe in the play call in the huddle there.
Second down, 10. And this is going nowhere. It's going to be third down and about 12 as Kelton Moore is stuffed. Gabe McCoy is there. It's a loss of two.
Great job defensively right here. McCoy getting off his block, number 25, in the tackle in the backfield. Had 12 tackles for loss this season heading into the game. And right now, too, as an offense, you got to start thinking, windy right now. My kicker didn't miss an extra point earlier in this game. We got to get as close as possible to make this a little bit easier for him.
At a 15 to 20 mile an hour crosswind right now. Shotgun snap. They're going to run it here. And Moore's going nowhere. Captured there by Jericho Flowers. It's a gain of one. And here comes the field goal team for Nevada. Ramiz Ahmed is the kicker. Now, Ahmed attended two schools, Arizona and UNLV, did not play football, ended up walking on and made the team at tryouts. He's from Bishop Gorman High School in Las Vegas. Sound familiar? Of course, that's where Tony Sanchez coached for 6 years. Snap, kick, and the crosswind is no worries for Ramiz Ahmed. Nevada has the lead. Back and forth they go in this great rivalry.
College football on CBS Sports Network is sponsored by Old Trapper Beef Jerky. What's your beef? By Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. And by Phillips 66, proud to be here.
the men and women of CBS Sports. And there is Paul Conley, PC as he's known. He has locked off a shot of the moon. Look at the focus, the crispness. I'm not sure who that guy is in the shot there. But PC's behind him, and PC held his shot despite the interloper in the booth. UNLV with the football. And he's bounced. It is Evan Owens at the 15-yard line. If you're just joining us, it's been a whale of a game so far. Nevada had a 23-0 lead. Yeah, 23-0. UNLV came storming back behind Armani Rogers. A field goal by Nevada. And the Wolfpack is up by a point. Look at that, 23-0, and nothing was going right. UNLV couldn't move it, they couldn't hold on to the ball, and their defense gave up points on the first four possessions by the Wolfpack. That's Evan Owens. And he's back to the line of scrimmage. There's a lot of fans here from, I'm sure from Reno, but there are Nevada fans that live in Las Vegas. They keep a low profile. I mean, look, it's two different states.
Yeah, they don't like each other.
Southern Nevada and Northern Nevada, it might as well be North and South Carolina, right? I mean, they are two very different states. But a good representation of Wolfpack fans here tonight.
Ball start, number 78, offense. 5-yard penalty, still second down.
And this is a tricky spot. You mentioned it, Aaron, talking about the wind and field position. And now with the penalty, it's backed up to the 10-yard line.
Yeah, but the thing is with Armani right now, he has the arm strength and he can spin it pretty well, where I don't think anything past 15 yards will affect his throw too much.
Play action, Armani rolling, little toss there, Giovanni Faolo, and he's dropped. Asani Rufus is making a lot of plays tonight.
It's a great job. Ran this play earlier to the left, just a three-level vertical. Asani Rufus staying home, not biting on the play action. We talked about it earlier, 326 career tackles heading in tonight, three career interceptions. He has been all over the field once again.
And a textbook tackle. Rogers under pressure, and he's hit and dropped. Malik Reed on the linebacker blitz. Reed, a hybrid player, he'll play the linebacker, he'll move up on the end.
And number 90 to the left of your screen. Great job with that right hand. And he is an animal. They move him from DN to linebacker. Third and long situations, they want him rushing the quarterback. So that's why you saw him put his hand in the ground right there, rush the right left tackle, and get that sack.
That was almost blocked. A spiraling kick by Hayes Hickens, and a good roll past midfield. And out of bounds at the 44-yard line. A one-point lead for Nevada. Nine-10 left in this ball game. 29-28, Nevada on top of UNLV.
Yeah, Kelton Moore has been very dominant. We're expecting Toa Taua, number 35, to have a field day, but it's been number 23. You see with the move, you see with the size, and then the speed once he breaks through the second and third level to take it distance for the touchdown. Has had a tremendous day. You see it, 119, you just saw the touchdown run. Fifth career 100-yard rush game. And he's had a tremendous job.
1-point lead with the ball. Ganji play action, swings it out. Caught there by Romeo Dubs. Flags come flying in. Dubs goes down after a 2-yard pickup. Jacquez Kalili and Dalton Baker there to make the stop. And officials conferencing.
It's going to be a high low block and the receivers on the outside.
Personal foul, chop block, number 33 and 49 of the offense. 15-yard penalty from the previous spot. Remain first down.
Yeah, they're both receivers are going to block on the end, just a swing route. Watch both these receivers up here. Gonna block the same guy, do a little high-low action. Usually see that. I think it was just a little bit miscommunication. Who's supposed to be blocking who? Both went after the same defender and got the chop block right there, which is huge right now. So all of a sudden it backs them up to first and 25.
You can't engage high and then block low, no matter if you're in or out of the tackle box.
And sometimes you just tell your receivers, just point out, who do you got? Communicate to each other.
So it's first down and 25. Ganji play action, fires to the sideline. Good throw and catch. Dubs again. And he's down to the 44-yard line. That picks up a good chunk of yardage, 14 on the throw. And it's second down and 11.
And that was a heck of a throw right there, because Gabe McCoy, number 25, you're going to see him drop back into coverage and throws a nice little, what we call a two ball. You're like, you're throwing over the goalpost, over the dropping linebacker right there. Get this to more of a second and manageable.
Bouncing it outside, Kelton Moore. And he lands right at midfield in the arms of Jericho Flowers. 6 yards on the carry. Third down now and about six.
That throw, two throws ago, that tremendous throw by Ty Ganji is pivotal, because now you get the ball around the 50-yard line. If you get the first down, that's awesome. It's tremendous. If you don't, though, you're able to flip field position with hopefully a great punt and then make UNLV drive the field. He doesn't complete that ball two plays ago. It could be a little different situation.
Third down. Ball right at midfield. Moore in motion. Blitz comes. Ganji gets rid of it and has a man. Caught at the 35 and down to the 25. Trey Carter Wells. Terrific reaction by Ty Ganji. 24 yards on the completion and run.
There he is right here. They're just going to run crossing routes again. You see the DBs get a little bit confused. Who's responsible for who? And that's what happens when you play man-to-man and guys start crossing, you lose your responsibility. We've seen it a few times tonight.
26-yard line on first and 10. Moore steps over a tackler and gets to the 21-yard line. Jericho Flowers was bracing for a big collision there. I mean, Moore's 5'11", 240, and instead of steamrolling him, Moore simply stepped right over him.
And Trey Carter, you just saw Wells, number 49. He's been great so far in blocking that big catch right there and taped up on the sideline. So hopefully he can get back in here in the next couple plays. See if he can get a little bit more involved inside the red zone.
1 point lead, Nevada moving. 21-yard line of UNLV. Not a good snap. Ganji catches it in traffic. It's picked off. Intercepted. Javen White for UNLV. White to the 40. Still on his feet. Midfield and into Nevada territory. Flag down. 37-yard line, and it came well after the interception. What a big play by UNLV's defense. Second interception of the night.
During the return, holding number 25 of the defense, 10 yards from the spot of the foul, remains UNLV's ball.
Well, important that the flag came after the pick.
Javen White right there does a great job not biting on the play action, stays home, keeps his eyes on the quarterback, and then drops right into the slant window to make the interception. That's a great job. This Nevada offense likes the motion guys out. We've seen it. Motion running backs from the backfield. A little bit of eye candy to distract the defenders. Javen White does a great job keeping his eyes where they need to be on the quarterback and then getting the interception.
That hold is going to cost UNLV about 30 yards of field position. Thomas, and a good tackle there. Coming up from a safety spot is Daylon Johnson. Remember, Damian Baber, the senior strong safety, one of the best defensive players Nevada has, was ejected. And you can see, for the second time, Gabriel Sewell is
banged up. Baber was ejected for targeting in the first half, and they miss him on defense. We'll step aside, a one-point Nevada lead. It's an odd injury for Gabriel Sewell, number 7 for Nevada in white.
Right there, you're just gonna see, watch the right ankle just get stepped on right there. Was actually helped off partly by his brother, which is pretty cool scene to see. We talked about it earlier, missing Baber. And then there's his brother right there, Nephi, helping him out. I don't know if I would have helped my brother up. I would have told him to suck it up. It's nice of him.
Second down. And bouncing it outside there, Xavier Campbell. Short of the first down. Third down and 2. Clock is under 6 minutes now.
And this is one of those third and shorts that Barney Cotton was talking to us about. They didn't convert these last week versus Hawaii, cost them the football game. Definitely helps having Armani back there at quarterback, though. Healthy, feeling good, and the threat of possibly running.
Oh, high snap. And straight ahead, Rogers is going to get the first down.
Rogers, the ball carrier.
And once again, that 6'5 frame being able to catch a bad snap. That ball came in there pretty hot, high into the right from the center. Watch this catch right there. I don't know, Rich, if I was back there at quarterback, my 6'1 frame, I don't know if I'm catching that one.
No, Aaron Murray would be turning and running to pick that up at the 10-yard line.
Listen, I got a good vertical, though. You know, I got some bunnies. I can jump up there and snag it. Just wouldn't have been as graceful as that.
First and 10, 38-yard line. Play action, Rogers, sideline shots, and overthrows the intended receiver, Brandon Presley. Second down and 10.
And the one issue the coaches want is look at the lower body locking out that left knee and not keeping a bend. You want to make sure as you step into a throw from a quarterback, you want to keep some kind of bend. That way your body's able to go through the throw. That will increase the accuracy. But they'll have time to work with him this offseason to improve a couple things.
Blitz comes, fires to the sideline, right on the money, right on time. Caught by Presley, has a first down. There's no question he is a unique athlete, this Armani Rogers guy.
What, the ball's already out of his hands. You see the top of the route right there from the receiver. The ball's out about a split second before Presley comes out of it, and that's just anticipation, trust, and having a great arm to make the throw to the outside.
Straight ahead on the ground. That's another 7-yard pickup, 43-yard line. If they can refine the throwing motion and add some touch, Rogers at 6'5", 225, he has skills that 90% of college quarterbacks don't have.
Yeah, he really does. I mean, watching him in warm-ups even a few weeks ago when we covered these guys, he wasn't playing, but just seeing him throw the football, you're like, this, he has everything you want. It's just refining a little bit things here and there, which is unfortunate why he couldn't play this entire season.
Owens right to the 40-yard line, and I think he's got the first down. He does. 3 yards is enough to move the chains. 3:58 left here in Las Vegas. A quick update from New York. Brent? Sending shockwaves, I'm sure, through Vegas. Rogers throw. Right at the 15, down to the 12. Fa'olo. Giovanni went up and got it and held it, and Rogers was right on the money.
And this is the same play they scored a touchdown on earlier. Both tight ends to the left, little play action, just a double post. And then great accurate throw, and then a great catch from Giovanni right there. Same play, we just saw the touchdown earlier. Came back to it, and a big completion inside the 20.
Nevada calls a timeout. They're on their heels. Armani Rogers and UNLV marching with 3:16 left in a rivalry game in the Mountain West. Tonight's player of the game is brought to you by Old Trapper Beef Jerky.
Yeah, it's definitely Armani Rogers. What he's done this entire football game, fully healthy. He's exciting to watch. There's the big touchdown to the tight end. The QB sneak using his 6'5 frame. And then his ability to throw on the run tonight has been impressive. We saw that one there. We saw a couple throws going to his left. And those are tough throws to make, but he's demonstrated accuracy, arm strength, and obviously the ability to run as well.
Now, if you're calling plays, if you're Barney Cotton, the offensive coordinator, you're in the red zone. You're just outside the 10.
I think you got to keep running the ball right here. You're running it well. The offensive line's doing a great job.
Rogers will keep it. Left side. Big man still on his feet. Now surrounded and stopped at the 6-yard line. And the clock is going to dip below 3. Nope. Jay Norvell hops out from the sideline, and he's going to call a timeout. So after a couple of timeouts, Nevada wants to make sure if UNLV gets points that there's time left on the clock.
Yeah, and that's a smart move right there. It is a big game, a lot of fun, and most importantly, the trophy. It's all about the trophy.
That's the biggest rivalry trophy in college football.
Trophy.
I mean, when we were in the coaches' offices at Nevada for the Boise State game, you and I went and tried to budge the cannon.
No luck.
No, that is heavy.
But I went back to the weight room after that pitiful performance, got my squat game up, so I might have to run on the field afterwards and try to push it around a little bit.
All right, football now sits at the 6. A first down can be had at about the 2.
I think the same thing right now. Like I said, offensive line's doing a great job. You had a mobile quarterback. Running backs are doing well. I continue running it.
On the ground, Owens. Right at the sticks, right at the 2. It's 3rd and inches or it's 1st and goal, depending on the spot. And the spot is a good one for UNLV. It is 1st and goal now, 3:02 left.
And right now the clock is the enemy. Enemy number one for Nevada at the moment. That's why Jay Norvell used that timeout the last play. And right now for UNLV, I just keep running it. Keep milking that clock.
Owens in the backfield, high snap, and Owens is stuffed. And I think Nevada's going to burn their last timeout here. They will.
That's a loss of a yard on the play.
Loss of a yard. Lucas Weber and Nephi Sewell came through to make the hit.
And you see all the downhill right there of the linebackers. I wouldn't be surprised if Barney Cotton saw that last play. If he saw that last play and maybe decides, hey, if we want to take a shot throwing the football, maybe once again, just like the last touchdown, a little play action to the running back, and then maybe sneak out a receiver or a tight end somewhere in the back of the end zone, because these defense is so far downhill.
We know that a lot of you are joining this game from other games, and if you're just happening by, this has been a crazy ride in a rivalry game. Nevada has a ton of momentum. Jay Norvell's team has won 4 in a row, and they opened up a 23-0 lead over UNLV, who's had a miserable season at 3-8. But that man right there, Armani Rogers, playing for his coach Tony Sanchez, has been a difference maker. And the Rebels down a point with 2:40 left in the ball game. 12th play of the drive. Rogers left side leaps and is in. Touchdown, UNLV.
Look at the left side of the offensive line right here, driving back the defensive line, putting them into the end zone. And that's easy work right there for Armani Rogers when the offensive line's blocking that great. And they should go for 2 right here. They're going to call a timeout, get it together, make sure they got a great play call.
Well, they get the 2. They're up by 7, and so it doesn't make sense to just kick it and go up by 6.
And right here, I think you got to move Rogers a little bit in the pocket somehow. Utilize his legs. We talk about the linebackers, the safeties downhill with the run action. Maybe some kind of play action. sneak someone out, and if no one's open, allow Armani Rogers do what he does best and take off and see if he can get the two-point conversion with his legs.
Rogers is out of Los Angeles, committed to Cal, ended up at UNLV. Known as a runner, he's been terrific as a thrower and a runner tonight. So now the conversion for two to stretch it to seven. Evan Rogers in the backfield. Deflected, incomplete, looking for Presley. Flag is down.
Yeah, it's an easy call on the outside. Going to be a holding, pass interference, whatever it is.
Pass interference, number 23, defense. Bills have to distance and go. Replay the try.
Yeah, Jamon Dotson got juked out with a slant on the inside from Presley. Understands that he's going to get beat to the outside. There's a smart thing in hold, at least gave his defense another opportunity to possibly stop this two-point conversion.
All right, you gain a yard and a half. Let's see if it changes the play call. Rolling to his right, Rogers running out of room, is caught and dropped. And Nevada holds on the conversion, but UNLV has a 34-29 lead. And remember, Nevada was driving, looking to add to their lead. Javen White with the pick. And then a long touchdown drive, finished by the big man, Armani Rogers. Not done yet in Vegas. Eagles is back there. 2.5 minutes left in this ball game. UNLV a 34-29 lead over Nevada. Rivalry game. They play for the Fremont Cannon. Nevada a 23-0 lead. First half seemingly on their way to a blowout win. But it changed with a defensive stop on fourth down. And that Fremont Cannon, which has been painted blue for the last 2 years, sits and waits. To the winner goes the Cannon. We're back to Vegas after this. Two minutes, 34 seconds left in this ball game. UNLV has the lead by five. Nevada has the ball with no timeouts left. Ty Ganji and the Wolfpack hot from the start, a 23-0 lead. But you can see what happened since that start. Two interceptions have been key in this comeback by UNLV.
And you're going to see UNLV most likely continue dropping eight, so only rushing three. Keep everything in front of them. Make that clock keep ticking away.
Ganji with time on the money there on the first throw. Short of the first down, clock will roll. No timeouts. Caleb Fossum with the catch. Gain of eight, second and two.
And Ganji needs to realize plenty of time. Take what the defense gives you. Just keep chipping away.
Again, three-man rush, short throw. Kelton Moore, the catch, has the first down. Clock will stop while they move the chains.
That's the perfect job right there. If the defense is going to give you 5 to 7, you take it. The clock's going to stop. Like I said, just keep going away. Right now, Fossum and Mannix in the slot. Look out for those two guys finding holes in the zone.
First and 10. Ganji back, a little deeper this time. Down the middle and caught there. Fossum has a first down into Rebel territory at the 48-yard line.
At some point, I wonder if UNLV is going to turn up the heat a little bit on defense. If you're going to continue playing zone, they're going to find the soft spots and exploit it.
Another first and 10. Time for Ganji. Swing pass out of the backfield. Moore is hit and stopped before he can get out of bounds. Clock will roll. Gain of two. Second and eight.
Plenty of time. No need to rush or hurry. Get lined up, get the play call, try snapping in about 15 seconds or less.
Second and eight. Ganji, sideline, it's picked! Intercepted! Javon White again! Unbelievable! And UNLV can run the clock out and capture the cannon! Flag is down.
After the play, unsportsmanlike conduct, number 26, Tawny. 15 yards will take from the end of the play. Remains first down, UNLV. That is number 26, first unsportsmanlike conduct of the game.
And what a play by Javon White, going up, getting vertical, and getting his second interception of the game to seal the deal. Ty Ganji just trying to make too much happen. Defense takes advantage once again. Like you said, seals the deal. I can feel that paint start chipping away. That trophy's gonna be red pretty soon.
Do you remember what the sideline looked like at the start of this game?
Oh, it was dead. Dead. The crowd was out of it. The players were out of it.
The coaches were out of it.
All of a sudden, get going a little bit. Armani makes a couple plays. You get an interception on defense. Defense has stepped it up. And you win one heck of a ball game.
It was 23 nothing. This will be the biggest comeback in UNLV history, and the cannon is on the move. The cannon has left the building, much like Elvis here in Vegas, much like the Rebels, who were down 23-0. Armani Rogers, the 6'5" sophomore, leads UNLV to an incredible comeback. And in a rivalry game, what a way to win it.
Like you said, to be out, everyone's counting you out. Fans are counting you out. Make an incredible comeback, biggest comeback in school history. That was fun to watch. That was fun to watch. Defense stepped it up, second quarter and on. Armani Rogers, the running backs, the offensive line. Give credit to those guys up front, they did a tremendous job. But Armani Rogers, sophomore, has some stuff to work on. But I tell you what, tonight was a huge step forward. Not just running the football, but taking and throwing it as well. That's a great sign right there. Two quarterbacks battling for their team all year. Friendship and happiness for each other is awesome to see.
When the Rebels get to their locker room, the cannon will be waiting. How emotional will that be? Seemingly a lost season for UNLV. 3-8 coming in, down 23-0 to their rivals. They rally at home and win it. A.J. Ross is down with Tony Sanchez. A.J.?
Coach Sanchez, a lot of momentum shifts in this game. Javon White with two interceptions. Your defense stepped up big. What does this mean for this team?
It's huge. It's been a tough year. You know, we came out playing so well the first four games, and we hit that six-week stretch. You know, Armani goes down. We have a bunch of injuries in the secondary. It would have been so easy for our guys to throw the towel in, but you know what? We got a bunch of really good older guys. We have some really talented young guys, and you saw the impact Armani had on the game tonight. It was unbelievable, but so proud of the defense. Being down 23-0, some teams are throwing the towel and they're done. And to come back and win that game, that's huge for Rebel football.
Fremont Cannon finally coming back here to the Rebel Stadium. What does this mean?
It's huge. You know, and the thing about it is we haven't had it a lot over the last 10, 15 years, you know, since Robinson. And our seniors go out having it 50% of the time. A lot of groups have never done that here, you know, again, since the Robinson days. So I'm proud of them. I'm just so happy for our seniors to go out with their names on a plaque.
Congratulations, Coach.
Thanks.
Thank you so much.
Rebs, appreciate it.
Thank you, AJ. Nice job tonight. Wow. Just unbelievable. It's 23-0 in a rivalry game and seemingly dead in the water. And the Rebels come roaring back. What a finish here. For Aaron Murray, AJ Ross, our entire CBS crew, I'm Rich Waltz. This has been a presentation of CBS Sports Network, 24-hour home of CBS Sports. So long from Las Vegas, back to our New York studios. Inside College Football. Brent Stover and Kevin Carter, the Rebels capture the cannon.
Rich, Aaron, AJ, the entire crew out in Vegas, tremendous work. What a football game. UNLV, hey, don't tell them that it's only going to be a 4-8 season. That was a tremendous comeback, down 23-0, and they beat Nevada. They shock them 34-29.
Yeah, Armani Rogers, the dual-threat quarterback for UNLV, just making people stand up and take notice, responsible for 5 touchdowns in this game. Outstanding comeback by their team, and they won the turnover battle, one of the big deciding factors in this ball game. Hats off to their performance tonight.
Rogers 13-21, 72 and 3 touchdowns. So that was a big result right there. It's the 4th win of the season to close out for UNLV. Nevada will finish the regular season at 7 wins.